We love the place, O Lord, wherein thine honour dwells. Destroy this temple, Jesus said, and in 3 days I will raise it up again. But the temple he was speaking of was his body. We welcome you to worship in St. Patrick's Cathedral at this Office of Evensong of the third Sunday in Lent.
O Lord, open thou our lips.
And
to the Son and to the
Here beginneth the first chapter of the book of Joshua. After the death of Moses, the Lord's servant, the Lord said to Joshua, son of Nun, Moses' assistant, now that my servant Moses is dead, get ready to cross the Jordan. You and all this people, to the land which I am giving to the Israelites. Every place where you set foot is yours. I have given it to you, as I promised Moses. From the desert and this Lebanon to the great river of the Euphrates, and across all the Hittite country westward to the great sea, all of it is to be your territory. As long as you live, no one will be able to stand against you. As I was with Moses, so shall I be with you. I shall not fail you or forsake you. Be strong. Be resolute. It is you who are to put this people in possession of the land which I swore to their forefathers I would give them. Only be very strong and resolute. Observe diligently all the law which my servant Moses has given you. If you would succeed wherever you go, you must not swerve from it either to right or to left. This book of the law must never be off your lips. You must keep it in mind day and night, so that you may diligently observe everything that is written in it. Then you will prosper and be successful in everything you do. This is my command. Be strong. Be resolute. Do not be fearful or discouraged. For wherever you go, the Lord your God is with you. Here endeth the first lesson.
For behold, Jesus went up to Jerusalem. In the temple precincts, he found the dealers in cattle, sheep, and pigeons. The money changers seated at their tables. He made a whip of cords and drove them out of the temple, sheep, cattle, and all. He upset the tables of the money changers, scattering their coins. Then he turned on the dealers and pigeons. Take them out of here, he said. And turn my father's house into a market. His disciples recalled the words of Scripture. Zeal for your house will consume you. The Jews challenged Jesus. What sign can you show to justify your action? Destroy this temple, Jesus replied. And in 3 days I will raise it up again. The Jews said it has taken 46 years to build this temple. Are you going to raise it up again in 3 days? But the temple he was speaking of was his body. After his resurrection, his disciples recalled what he had said, and they believed the scripture and the words that Jesus had spoken. Here endeth the second lesson.
Church, the communion of saints. saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Our Lord.
Amen.
counsels and all just works to proceed. Give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness. Through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thy only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The temple he was speaking of was his body. The Hebrew nation defined herself by three things: temple, Torah, or law, and land. The temple at Jerusalem was a special place because it was where God's presence dwelt. It was the closest place people could come to God. We Christians have inherited something similar. God is everywhere, and therefore rather difficult to worship. So we concentrate his presence in our temple, here, in the cathedral. We love the place, O God, wherein thine honour dwells. The fates suffered by the temple in Jerusalem, raised by Solomon, and replaced by David, and in turn by King Herod, reflected the stages of conquest and exile experienced by the Hebrew people. Jesus taught us that we, his followers, form a spiritual temple with himself as the cornerstone, a living temple in which all have access to God. You and I are living stones. We are the church. We are the place of encounter between God and his people. The words of Walmsley's anthem that forms today's sermon come from the Lamentations of Jeremiah, in which the prophet weeps over Jerusalem and her temple. She was destroyed by the Babylonian army, and her citizens were expelled. This was the consequence of their disobedience, of their arrogance, and their failure to repent. The words you're about to hear sung sum this up in such a mournful way. But God relented when his people turned again to him. This season of Lent sets you and me the challenge of returning, of seeking God's mercy, even though your heart and mind are faint. God remains constant. When we remember the Lord, we pray, remember, O Lord, what is come upon us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Remember, O Lord, what has come upon us. Consider and behold our reproach. There is no place where earth's sorrows are more keenly felt than heaven. Almighty God, heal the sorrows of your children and do not afflict us for the multitude of our sins. When our enemies prosper, turn again our captivity, O Lord God, so that we who now walk in the shadow of death may return to you through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The joy of our heart is ceased, and our doubts is turned into mourning. But we make God's love too narrow by false limits of our own. Arise, O Lord, deliver your people and rouse us from the sleep of sin. For as your Son offered up prayer with tears in the days of his flesh, so hear his heavenly intercession for us, that though we may be tempted in every way as we were, we likewise may not fall into sin. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thou, O Lord, remainest forever. Thy throne is from generation to generation. If our love were but more simple, we should take God at his word. Almighty God, in our baptism you have consecrated us to be temples of your Holy Spirit. May we, whom you have counted worthy, nurture your indwelling spirit with a lively faith and worship you with upright lives through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us gather all our prayers into one by praying together the words of the grace. The grace
of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore.
Amen.
Thank you.
Christ and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen.